Sup guys, it is the Cornish Gamer, and welcome back to another episode of my Civilization 5 Brave New World series as Netherlands. Anyway, as we always do at the beginning of an episode, we have a look at take a look at the demographics. You can see Aztec's still top on literacy, however we have caught up to them. We're top on approval with our 36 happiness, which is insane. Shoshone are top on soldiers, top on land, no surprise. We're top on GNP, Shoshone are top on... Sorry about that noise, actually. Yeah, sorry about that. Top on second on manufactured goods in the crop year, with Shoshone first again. And we're top on population. Just warning you, that noise may happen again. It's kind of like that noise. It's kind of like an indoor washing line. Yeah, it's difficult to explain. But anyway, we've got all our city-state allies. Alright, we can't create great work, but we should try and like go towards maybe the Sistine Chapel or the Uffizi, because we have got aesthetics. However, I don't want to get astronomy as well, because I do want to find the people on the other continent. Anyway, we'll decide that in a bit. And we want to grab economics as well to make the polls really, really stand out, because if we have like economics, Polders plus 2 gold and plus 1 production, which will be insane. Rotterdam will be an amazing naval base. Yep, sorry about that again. Yeah, it's really not a nice noise, is it? My room's right above where it is, so... sorry about that. Anyway. This guy's out exploring, wasn't he? Yeah, I sent him out exploring. Alright. Yeah, sorry about that noise, your ears will probably burst, but oh well. Renaissance here. We want to grab the Forbidden Palace, actually. Because once again, I'm aiming for several different victories, and, you know, just seeing which one works. We got a spy, so we'll send that to... I'll send it to Shoshone, because to be honest, I don't really trust them. How's our culture doing, actually? It's not bad. It's not amazing. Choose research. Should we go towards Uffizi? Should we go towards economics? I really don't know what to do, really. If we go towards that, we'll go straight there. If we go towards astronomy, if we go towards... Mind you, printing press will be useful. I think I'm going to go for physics. Wait until we get more universities. We got one there. I'm not sure if we've got one here or not. Just purchase one. Alright. I think we can settle a new city. I think it's time. Because our three cities here have developed very well. However, where we're going to settle this new city is a problem. I mean, we've got the happiness to settle. I'd like to... We may have to settle reasonably far away from where we actually are. Because there's no real space in Africa due to all the city-states being there. I guess we could settle down here. However, the desert does make it pretty crap. I mean, it would be good if we could build polders there, but we can't. I like somewhere where we could really, really use the polders. Do we have dyes? We already have dyes for trading. However, if we were to settle there... No, that isn't a good idea. I don't know, we might have to just have to stick with three cities, because there's nowhere we can really settle, is there? Monster 2, which is set at the Renaissance era. Yep, sorry about that again. There's so many distractions in this game so far. I'm going to say, recording you mug. Yeah, this episode isn't going well when it comes to distractions, really. Hopefully you guys are still here, I hope. Alright, monastery. Yeah, as we have monastery, let's see why not. Wow. Alright. There's nothing we can work. I think we'll build some boats. And then, once we get the caravel, we'll be able to send the boats out to explore. We may be able to settle on Australia, actually. because there's usually a bit of space in Australia if someone hasn't settled there already. Because nobody really ever spawns on Australia, which is good. So we could try and settle there, maybe, if it's good enough. Because your friendship has expired with Siam. I'd like to renew that. Okay, good. Bank would be nice. We could be able to build the Oxford University in 2 turns. We may as well build something that takes 2 turns. Like, actually, we want to build cargo ships coming out of here. Let's purchase a cargo ship. Because cargo ships earn a lot more gold than anything else. Forbidden Palace is what we're going to want to work on. Forbidden Palace usually doesn't get grabbed by anyone. Because nobody usually really ever goes for it. Like, he's gone after aesthetics, he's gone for pages, he could grab it. However, I can't see any wonders being built. He can't. Neither can he. Of course the civs, like, in other places may be able to, but... you know. I'm getting loads of science from these jungles. Oh, you could pump food into Utrecht. However, I don't really think that's needed. It's doing fine by itself. I mean, we already are pumping production into it, which is really helping it. I think we'll trade with Sukhothai. Our allies. I just want DLN then. And I just casually skip past it. We've got so many luxuries. Just look. It's ridiculous. Citrus. Oh, he hates me. Yeah, don't particularly think he likes me. He's hostile with me, isn't he? Yeah, everyone's denounced him. I'm tempted to attack him. Because everyone's denounced him, it won't be that bad. I mean, I think the Shoshone's already working on him. But I feel as if I can... I feel as if they're a threat to the world. And taking them down won't be a bad thing. Is anyone else's culture kind of... doing well. Aztec's on 6. That's pretty good. So I am. Shoshone. Sweden. You can see the Aztecs are actually doing well in culture. We're 2nd. Tririm. You stay here. Would Oxford here. Alright. We'll build a market here. And we'll go for... yeah, we want the additional trade route. Let's go for compass. Right. It seems if we are void of any distractions. Hooray. So we might actually be able to carry on without any distractions, but I doubt it. Like a great engineer to rush it. We're generating 10 food from Amsterdam. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Alright, Kabul, hello. Where on earth are you? So we know there's 16 city states. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright, where's Kabul? Where's Kabul? Ah, there. Are they hostile? Yeah, that their influence will drop quicker. Wait, what social policy track are we getting now? Patronage, yeah. Alright. Yeah, everyone's pretty protecting Kabul. I'll just take care of my cities. Yeah, we'll take the gold. We're just freaking rolling in gold. Forbidden Pass will be nice. Yeah, we'll go for Decoration of Friendship. See, I feel as if we attack Sweden, we won't actually get a warmonger penalty. Or not a very big one, at least. Since everyone likes us, generally... apart from Sweden. And everyone hates Sweden at the moment. They're war with everyone. They're war with Netherlands, Japan, the Aztecs, and Siam. Practically everyone we've met. I think it is everyone we met. Like, yeah, war with Japan. Japan, Aztecs, Siam. Oh, no, that isn't war. At war with the Shoshone. This has been denounced. caravan. Where are you going? Go back. 13 gold, we'll take that. And we'll go for... Gold gives 25% more influence. We only really want to go for the first... Ooh, hello. That is good. That is really good. Even better than going for rationalism if we ally with loads. That is very good. If we can ally with as many as possible. Plus Forbidden Palace, that could be very, very good. Like, we're talking a lot more science. No, we're not going to go for that. Thank you. Rather keep the happiness. I mean, I know we only lose two, but still. Alright. Have we got incense? We've pretty much got everything, right? Incense, yeah. Compass. First a Pocatello. Ah, we only have one copy. Should we have astronomy? That would generate science. Oh, it's not next to the mountain, is it? It was near. I remember now. Sea beggars. Now they are good. Most of our good stuff comes in the Renaissance era. The Netherlands really are powerful in the Renaissance era. So, I think we'll go for astronomy. Get that frig out to a caravel. See about Australia, and then go to the Americas. See what's there. Let's see if we've got Alhambra. Oh no. But we will want to get the Uffizi as well. So we can store some great artists. Because we're getting another one in 11 turns. Plus the free one when you get the Uffizi, we'll be able to completely fill it up. Which is good. I mean, like, gaining influence over people not only benefits you, like, cultural-wise, but it also benefits, like, wait, it's trade. No, it's not there anymore. But it also benefits us, trade route-wise. I believe we gain more science, and if we are to take them over, then we lose less population per city. Yeah, open borders. So, if we do get quite high influence over Sweden, then yeah. Wait, so you only get Swedish Empire. Swedish Empire is around the same military strength. Our military strength isn't that high, is it? No, it's like average. I kind of want to stay around there. We're top on literacy now, I just noticed there. We should be able to get Forbidden Palace, right? It looks like that. Are they building it? No. So we should be alright. Should we make another city-state ally? We've got the money. Let's do it. I mean, it's got the 20% more, like, can I go anger wolf, Bucharest? What do you guys want? Is it a natural wonder? Great generate great admiral? No, natural wonder. Towers into kind of the majority of addition in the city. And we'll see. Let's make allies of Almaty. Alright. What are they going to give us? They're militaristic, so they should give us African forest elephant. So they'll give us that. Nice. I suppose we can get one of our military units from city-states if we ally with enough. Also the caravel, once we get it, will help with like finding city-states. Which is good. So I like our empire, although it's not massive. It's still getting along just fine. Trade route plundered. Let's go investigate this. Oh, hello. Research agreement complete. Man, I don't want... It's annoying. I was liking that trade route. Alright. Yeah, alright. We'll take the open borders as well for the influence, culturally. But this is generally how I play Civ games on higher difficulties. I play for several different victories, just so if one fails, then I've always got a backup. And I know the culture one isn't strong, but we're also strong for a science victory, you have to remember. We are towards the top on science. So we already have three victories we can go for, which is good. There's that pesky tririum. Ah, we need this tririum back, so now we can get to a caravel. 4 turns until Forbidden Palace. Captain Cabal, are you still away from my city states? Ah, oh, Cabal and my allies, damn it. Ah, crap. Send this guy over. I think we should just place a unit there just to protect. I reckon we might need 2 caravels, actually. One to explore the Americas, one to explore Australia. Alright, we're gonna go for Ufitsi now. No, we're gonna go for economics. Machinery printing press, and trust me, it will be worth it. It will be worth it. To get the massive polder bonus, which will make Rotterdam even more stronger than it already is. All it's really lacking at the moment is production. And with the +1 production and +2 gold, that'll be an additional 5 production and an additional 10 gold per turn, which will be extremely powerful. Stop pillaging tiles. Stop it. Oh, after machinery we'll be able to upgrade them, because we have a lot of composite bowmen in 1290, which isn't good. They're still exploring. Sweden protecting Bucharest and protecting Kabul. Bucharest and they're our ally. Yes, you better stay away, bitch. They're our allies. If you honest want Quebec City bullied. No. Why are you pissed off? Oh crap. Oh. Well, that was a very smart idea, wasn't it, going out to sea? Should we just build one? May as well buy one, we've got the money. We'll build a cargo ship? Yeah. We could establish a trade route with Byblos. We'll keep a unit here. There must be a Bahrain camp around here. It's not there. I reckon it's somewhere up here in between Malacca and Sukhothai. Because when we sent our Turin there, we couldn't see it. This... get over it. They're ours. We were allies first. Ah, we're getting a free tech. We'll take that very, very nicely. Forbidden Palace. I've only ever got this wonder twice in Civ. Which is interesting. I don't think I've actually got every... like, thing. Every wonder in this game. Which is... I should have. Oh, sea beggars. We'll take that. And now we can start building sea beggars. Alright. Who was it that wanted our religion? Kabul. How long's it got? How long's the quest got? Oh, he doesn't say. Bit annoying. Sea beggars. Could put an East India Company here as well. Considering our special ability is the Dutch East India Company. We'll put it in the capital. May as well. These cities, yeah, they are connected. Good. I agree, he has become a nuisance, however, I don't want to attack him yet. I may attack him. However, I'm kind of scared of the warmonger penalty, despite how much everyone hates him. I still think the warmonger penalty can be deadly in this game, as I learned on my Assyria series. Yeah, you can see it takes 9 turns for the sea beggars, we definitely do need that improvement. Alright, let's upgrade all these guys. Oh, there you go. So it means you have to go towards the bottom of the upgrading thing on this UI mod. And it only seems to be for upgrade unit. You sort of have to go around the corners. I think that's everyone? Yeah. Because I haven't got the Uffizi yet. You go for Australia. I'm actually talking about the Dutch East India Company. That is India there. That little thing coming out, I believe. I may be wrong, but I think it is. I do agree, mate. Alright, I'm going to take a risk here, guys. Give us 10 turns to prepare. And we will attack Sweden. Because it seems like everybody has a bone to pick with him. And I feel as if I want to, if despite the warmonger penalty, I feel as if people will like me if I do attack Sweden. And I want to stay relatively peaceful on this. Unless needs be, just like Sweden. Alright, you go there. There. Alright, customer new guard. Alert. Great profits heading over towards Almaty. Okay, we need to start churning out units. East India Company can wait. Ironworks would be useful, but not now. We'll go. Mainly crossbowmen comprised army. Swordsmen. How big is our army in comparison? Doesn't have strong military as us, and they're getting attacked by several other people. Let's move over a few units. I think that should be sufficient. Just leave one there. And then probably move in this swordsman as well. And then we'll build these swordsmen just to protect our lands while they're gone. Kamhang has declared war on Gustavus Adolphus. And I reckon the Aztecs will soon as well. And I reckon... Why is... Yep, sorry about that again. Really sorry. It's nothing I can really do. Golden Age. Great. Panama. Alright. Good. And Zanzibar. Stuff for you, Sweden. I'm going to be allied with Zanzibar soon. Alright, move up. Move up. Oh, we got a knight. Thank you. Move up. Move up. Okay. I think we're going to end this episode here. Thanks for watching this episode, guys. I'll just quickly move our caravel. Be sure to like, subscribe, share with your friends, add to your favourites, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.